Hi, in this video I am going to discuss introduction to the heterocyclic chemistry. So first of all, what is mean by homocyclic and heterocyclic? Nothing but cyclic compounds. So homocyclic means nothing but alicyclic or carbocyclic. So that means compounds contain ring made up only carbon atoms. So if you see the examples here, benzene and cyclohexanol and cyclopentadiene. So all these rings having only carbon atom in the ring system. So the compounds contain ring made up of only carbon atoms, we can consider it as a homocyclic. And you can see the variation between this homocyclic and heterocyclic. This hetero is indicating other than carbon, any atom is present, we can consider it as a hetero atom. So the compounds contain ring made up of carbon atoms and other kind of atoms. That means mostly commonly we are observing the hetero atoms are nothing but nitrogen, oxygen and sulfur. So either this may be heterocyclic groups, heterocyclic compounds may be aromatic or it may be non-aromatic. So as we know clearly that aromatic, it is nothing but following of the aromatic sextet, that is 6 pi electrons are present in the ring system. So the examples we can see under this aromatic heterocyclic compounds like pyrrole, furan, thiophene. So these are 5 membered ring systems with hetero atom of nitrogen, oxygen and sulfur. So here the lone pair of electrons present on the hetero atom donates that electrons into the ring system and containing of aromatic sextet. So non-aromatic, so this is also heterocyclic only but it is not aromatic. So those are coming under non-aromatic heterocyclic, there is no double bonds. So these are hydrogenated compounds of these aromatic heterocyclic compounds. So it is tetrahydrofuran, it is tetrahydrothiophene and it is pyrrolidine. So this is the difference between the homocyclic and also heterocyclic compounds. So you can see clearly about the heterocyclic and its nomenclature and its trivial names and IUPAC names. So comes to the heterocyclic. So what a heterocyclic compound? So as we seen in the previous slide, so if the ring is system is made up of carbon atoms and at least one other element, the compound can be classified as heterocyclic. So other than with carbon, any other hetero atom is present, we can consider as a heterocyclic. So as hetero atom can be either nitrogen or oxygen or sulfur, boron, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus. Likewise, we can see the different elements we can observe. Among these, what we are mostly finding are the nitrogen, oxygen and sulfur. So you can see here, this is homocyclic. By presence of any hetero atom, so we can see it is as a heterocyclic compound. So heterocyclic compounds are organic compounds that contain a ring structure containing atoms in addition to carbon such as sulfur, oxygen or nitrogen as the hetero atom. The ring may be aromatic or non-aromatic, what we seen in the previous slide with the examples. Significance. So what is the significance of this heterocyclic compound? So 2/3 of all organic compounds are aromatic heterocyclics. Most pharmaceuticals are heterocyclic also, you can observe in the medicinal field. So what is the nomenclature you can observe for this heterocyclic compounds? So there are two systems we can see for naming of heterocyclic compounds, like trivial or common names and systematic or IUPAC names. So which conveys the little or no structural information but it's still widely using this trivial names, common names. So it is not a meaning of the structure, it is not representing the information of the structure, but still widely we are using these trivial names for the most of the heterocyclic compounds. And systematic or IUPAC name means it is by the Hands-Widman method. So which in the contrast is designed so that one may deduce from the structure of the compound. So based upon the structure of the compound, they are giving the IUPAC name, that is International Union for Pure and Applied Chemistry, the replacement method. So first we can see heterocyclic nomenclature basing upon a trivial or common names. We can see for the heterocyclic compounds what are the different names. So trivial names are still preferred for some heterocyclic compounds. So some monocyclic compounds of this kind are shown with a common trivial. Some monocyclic compounds of this kind are shown in the following chart. So we can see these examples are given here. So ethylene oxide. So two carbons are present. We can consider as a ethylene oxide, presence of oxygen. Ethylene imine, imine is present, and trimethylene oxide, 1, 2, 3, trimethylene oxide. It is a furan, we can call it as oxol, as a IUPAC name. So the upper name, that is with the black letters, it is a trivial name, what mentioned here. And the downside, what it is present in a blue color, that is indication of IUPAC name for the compound. So oxol, it is furan. Tetrahydrofuran, we can call it as oxolane, that is IUPAC name. It is thiophane, that is a trivial name for the 5-member ring with a sulfur atom, and the IUPAC name is thiol. And it is azole. So azo indicating the nitrogen atom, ol is indicating the 5-member ring system. So the trivial name is pyrrole. So it is pyrrolidine. You can call it as azolidine as a IUPAC name. So like pyran, pyridine, piperidine, imidazole, thiazole, dioxane, morpholine, pyrimidine. So mostly you can see this pyrimidine, dioxane, thiazole, imidazole. These trivial names only mostly popular for these heterocyclic compounds rather than the IUPAC names. So in the IUPAC nomenclature of heterocyclic compounds, so we need to follow some systematic guidelines. So how we are giving the nomenclature to the heterocyclic compounds? So the hetero atom is to be counted as 1 or as a low as possible. So always we should give the preference to the hetero atom in the ring system, that is with the number 1. When there is no more than one hetero atom, preference is given to oxygen, then sulfur, then nitrogen. So more than one hetero atom, if you are observing in the ring system, so you can give the priority order to the hetero atoms. So first we are giving to the preference to the oxygen, then to the sulfur, then to the nitrogen, and then to the carbon atom. So also NH presides over N, that is imine, me no maker. So old soldiers never cry. So this is a pattern we can remember, the priority order of the hetero atoms, OSNC. So that is indicating that old soldiers never cry. So the first one is the periodic tech number 1. So if the second element are the same, we use di, tri, tetra or before the prefix. So for example, if the more than one hetero atom with a similar hetero atoms, two nitrogen atoms are present, means we can mention it as a di. Three nitrogens present means tri. Four nitrogens present means tetra. So likewise, we can give the prefix to the compound. So when there is a more than one hetero atom, so numbering should be as directed as possible from one to another. So always we should give the preference to one hetero atom to the next hetero atom with the least numbering. So substances are numbered as low as possible, and acceptable prefixes include oxa, thia, and aza. So the hetero atoms mostly we are seeing in the heterocyclic compounds are oxygen, sulfur, nitrogen. That's why you can see the prefix for these hetero atom containing compounds oxa, thia, and aza. So oxa indicating the oxygen, thia indicating the sulfur, aza indicating the nitrogen. So common suffixes for the nitrogen and in heterocyclic for partially unsaturated systems are used to indicate the location of the saturation. So this we can see clearly in the next slide. So Hans-Widman system of the systematic name of the heterocyclic compounds, finally prefixes are dropped from the AAOOL. So see here this table indicating the ring containing nitrogen atom, ring without nitrogen atom. So if the ring system, heterocyclic ring system containing with the nitrogen or without nitrogen, so what will be the suffix we can give to the molecule? So prefix we seen, that is oxa, thia, aza. So what will be the suffix to the nomenclature? So that will be basing upon the presence of nitrogen or absence of nitrogen, either it may be saturated or unsaturated. So basing upon this, we can see the different nomenclature we can represent. So for example, ring size 3, so that means rings, 3 membered ring system. So the unsaturated means irine and saturation means iridine. This is a suffix we can give. So for example, here the 3 membered ring system with the nitrogen atom, so we can consider as a azirin. So it is a second position, it is having the double bond, so you can call it as a 2H azirin. So here there is no double bond, it is completely saturated. Saturation means there is no presence of double bond, so we can consider it as a aziridine. So this is the suffix will come. Aza is indicating the nitrogen atom, iridine indicating the 3 membered ring system with saturation. So similarly, 4 membered ring with the unsaturation, we can give the suffix is eat. So here we can see that the example azite. So aza indicating the nitrogen and eat is indicating the 4 membered ring with unsaturation, so azite. So itidine, so it is indicating the 4 membered ring system with the saturation, that means azitidine. So likewise, 5 membered rings, unsaturation means ol, saturation means olidine. 6 membered ring ine and prehydro in the saturation. 7 membered ring ipine, prehydro in the saturation condition. So similarly, ring without nitrogen, so these examples are coming under the with nitrogen atom. Without nitrogen means we can see the variation in the suffix in the case of saturation and also in the unsaturation. So in the case of 3 membered ring system, unsaturation means irene, so here irene is there, so here irene is there, so it is irene in the saturation. So in a 4 membered ring, so eat both are similar, and etane in the case of saturation. And 5 membered ring, ring system, so unsaturation is same, ol, there is no change, so here we can see saturation olane. 6 membered ring, unsaturation ine, and here also same we can observe, but in the case of saturation ane. And 7 membered ring system, same it is epine, so here also epine. So in the case of saturation, this prehydro and here is the epane. So here see the clearly examples represented here. So you can see this 7 membered ring system with without nitrogen, so with unsaturation. So unsaturation means presence of double bond, so oxane is present, oxa is the prefix, oxy, pin is indicating the 7 membered ring system, that is unsaturated 7 membered ring with without nitrogen. And you can see here there is no double bonds here, so it is completely saturated, so oxy pin. So this is the epane is indicating the saturation of the compound. So oxypane, we can give the IUPAC name. So you can see 5 membered ring system, ol. So that is unsaturation indicating, for example, oxol. The trivial name is the furan. And it is tetrahydrofuran without double bonds. It is saturation condition. We can give the name, that is olane, as a suffix to the oxa prefix. Oxolane, that is indicating the IUPAC name of this tetrahydrofuran. So likewise, we can give the nomenclature for the heterocyclic compounds, ring containing nitrogen and ring without nitrogen. See the ring size, erane, 4 member ring, etane, olane, inane, epane, okane. So it is saturated, partially saturated, unsaturated. So likewise, we can give the nomenclature. So the common name is ethylene oxide. So the systematic name we can give, oxa is indicating the prefix, oxygen. Erane is indicating the presence of saturated 3 membered ring system, oxyrane. So you can see here this pyrrole. So it is a trivial name or common name we can observe for this ring system with the one nitrogen atom in 5 member ring system. So systematic name, hydrogen at first position. So hydrogen at first position plus aza. Aza is indicating the nitrogen plus ol. Ol is indicating the unsaturated group. So the most common heterocyclic nitrogen ring system, 5-member ring systems, unsaturated, saturated. So unsaturated pyrrole, that is one nitrogen atom with 5-member ring system, pyrazole, imidazole, 1,2,3-triazole, 1,2,4-triazole, tetrazole. So these are the common 5-member ring system with nitrogen atoms. So in the case of saturated, that means there is no double bonds, pyrrolidine, pyrazolidine, so two nitrogens are present adjacent, pyrazole, saturated condition, pyrazolidine, and it is a lactam. So ortho position, the keto group is present to the NH, so you can call it as a lactam ring system. That means presence of all double bonds, pyridine, and it is a pyrimidine. So you can see 1,2 meta position is present, these two nitrogens, and ortho position are present, these two, pyridazine, and para position, these two are present, pyrazine. So it's mostly the confusing by the students, pyridine, pyrimidine, pyridazine, and pyrazine. And in the case of pyridine, completely saturated condition, we can consider it as a pyperidine. And pyrazine, in the case of complete saturation, so we can consider it as a pyperazine. So these 6-member ring system with the nitrogen having important in the DNA bases. So in the uracil, so it is a pyrimidine derivative. Similarly, thymidine, cytosine. So all comes under the pyrimidine analogs. So nitrogen heterocyclic rings, fused ring systems. So fused means one ring is attaching with the another ring. So most commonly we are observing this fused ring system containing nitrogen atom. So pyrimidine along with imidazole. So mostly in the case of DNA bases, so this type of combination we are observing, DNA bases, pyrimidine with imidazole. So pyrimidine means 6-member ring with two nitrogens at the meta position, both are present, and imidazole, it is a 5-member ring system with the same meta position, these are present. So this is the purine, that is pyrimidine imidazole nucleus, we can consider as a purine. And at the position of here, amino group is present, we can call it as adenine. And here, double bond O and NH2, we can see presence of guanine. And benzene fused. So here, hetero ring system is fusing with the hetero ring system. Both are heterocyclic ring systems. But here in the case of these examples, so heterocyclic ring system is attaching with the benzene ring system. So here is pyrrole is fusing with the benzene, 1H indole, that is a trivial name, and it is quinoline, pyridine linking with the benzene, quinoline, and that is isoquinoline. The presence of nitrogen in this position can call it as isoquinoline. So next important most heterocyclic oxane heterocyclic ring systems. So in the case of 5-member furan, that is oxane with 5-member ring system, and tetrahydrofuran, there is no double bonds here, saturated condition of furan, tetrahydrofuran, and it is lactone. So previously we seen lactam, but it is lactone, that is tetrahydrofuran, adjacently that ortho position having the keto group, lactone. 6-member ring cyst like pyrone, that is 2-pyrone, second position having the double bond O, 4-pyrone, 1,4-dioxane, and pyrrolium cation. So plus charge is present to the oxygen atom. So 4H pyran. So this is a 4H pyran. Similarly, as like nitrogen atom, oxygen also having the benzene fused compounds. So it is benzofuran. Furan is binding with the benzene, and it is coumarin. So it is nothing but pyrone. So pyrone is attaching with the benzene ring system. So you can call it as coumarin. And this 4-pyrone. 4-pyrone, so you can call it as chromone. And chromine means nothing but this is the structure of chromine. So these are the important scaffolds we can observe in the different medicinal compounds. Next, in the case of sulfur containing heterocyclic ring systems, the unsaturated, that is presence of double bond, thiophene, 5-member ring system with sulfur atom, bench thiophene fused with the benzene ring system, thiophene, and thiopyran, presence of 6-member ring with sulfur, and thiophene, so that is 7-member ring with sulfur containing compound. So we can see heterocyclic rings with two different heteroatoms. Up to now we see the single heteroatom only. Now we can observe the different hetero atoms are present. Nitrogen and oxygen. So you can see oxa-azole. Oxa-azole. Ol is indicating the final ring. Isoxazole. And 1, 2, 3. Oxa-diazole. 1, 3, 4. 1, 3, 4. Oxa-diazole. 1, 2, 4. Oxa-diazole. Morpholine. So this is a ring structure. We can consider as a morpholine. So oxygen we can give the preference. Then we are giving to the nitrogen. And we are representing the suffix as a ring system. Ol is indicating the 5-membered ring system. And in the case of nitrogen and sulfur, thiazole, thiazole. So sulfur we can give the preference here when comparing with the nitrogen. So that's why giving the prefix like thiazole. Thiazole, 5-membered ring indicating the ol. First position and third position. And 1-2 position, sulfur and nitrogen are there. 1-2 thiazole. 1, 2, 3, thia, dia, aza, ol. Two nitrogens are present, that's why dia, azole. And 1, 3, 4, thia, di, aza, ol. 1, 2, 4, thia, diazole. 1, 2, 3, 4, thia, triazole. So likewise, we can give the more than one hetero atoms are present in the ring systems. So you can see how we are giving the nomenclature in the fused systems. So numbering we can give in the heterocyclic compounds. So when numbering is in the ring system of hetero atom, we can give the preference to the 1. So here we can see one example. By the example we can understand benzofuran, benzene with furan. So where we can start the numbering in this ring system is always we should prefer the hetero atom where it is located. So it is number 1 position, 1 we are giving. And next we are going to 2, 3, 4, 5. So you can see this example benzothiapine. So 7-membered ring system with the sulfur atom. So sulfur atom can give the preference 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 we are giving. So here we can observe the A and B we are representing here. So the bond between the hetero atom and benzene ring system, so you can consider as A. And next to that bond is B. So this is the important we can see. So how the benzene is attaching with the furan. So at the B part of the furan is binding with the benzene. B bond is binding with the benzene. So you can call it as benzo B furan. So here D is attaching, benzo D thiapine. So here you can see in the case of pyrrole with the benzene ring system, benz pyrrole. So the B position is attaching, benz pyrrole. So similarly, quinoline, that is benzo B pyridine. So here it is benzo F quinoline. So here you can see clearly hetero atom here is 1. So adjacently you can give the numbering A, B, C, D, and this is E and this is the F. So this total structure is quinoline. So this quinoline is attaching with the benzene. So benzo F quinoline. So numbering we are giving 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So here it is thiophene. So 1 we are giving here, 2, 3, 4, 5 and giving the bond here A, B, C. C is attaching with the benzene. So benzo C thiophene. So this is the mostly confusing with the students. So just go through clearly. And this bond, how it is attaching the ring system, that we are representing in the nomenclature benzo B furan. So priority order of component ring systems, selection of the parent or base ring is based on the following rules and which are applied in the order. So nitrogen, oxygen and sulfur. So you can see here the naming of this compound. So you can take this oxygen and sulfur preferent. O preferred to sulfur. Yes, furan. So that is when seeing the order, heterocyclic ring systems containing earlier in the order nitrogen, oxygen and sulfur. So we can consider as a parent ring system, furan. So you can give the name 7H, indicating that there is hydrogen present here without double bond. 7H, thiopyranofuran, thiopyran. So pyrano means nothing but this ring system. Thio is indicating the sulfur, pyranofuran. So here in this ring system, so it is a substituent ring pyrano and we can give the preference to the nitrogen. So when comparing with the oxygen, nitrogen is more preferred. So this is how we can consider as a parent ring and this is a substituent. So here A, B, C part is attaching. So it is 2-3 position. So pyrano 2,3-C-pyrrole. So the substituent, it is attaching at which position? Second position, third position, it attaching to the parent nucleus. That is at the C position of the parent nucleus. So that's why we can give the IUPAC name pyrano 2,3-C-pyrrole. So this is the nomenclature we can observe for the various heterocyclic compounds with the single containing hetero atom and more than one hetero atom and fused ring systems. Thank you for watching. So please subscribe to my channel if you are new to my channel and forward this video to your friends. Thank you. Thank you for watching.